In this video, you'll learn how to render a model with StereoKit. If you're unfamiliar with the steps to set up a StereoKit project, refer to the project setup videos for guided instruction on project setup. For this video, we'll be using the StereoKit Universal Windows Platform template. In the Solution Explorer, there's an assets folder in program.cs script. The assets folder is where you can store assets such as model files. The program.cs script contains the application logic. For this example, we'll place the flight helmet model files in the assets folder and replace the sample code in the program.cs script with code that will render the flight helmet model. Be sure to include all files associated with the model, such as the bin file and textures, into the assets folder. Let's open program.cs to add the logic. The code first starts by initializing StereoKit. During initialization, you can prepare a few settings like the app name and assets folder. The app name is the name of the app and appears at the top of the Win32 window if viewing your app in flat screen mode. In addition, the app name is also submitted to OpenXR, which caps at 128 characters. The assets folder is the folder that StereoKit will use to look for assets. You can refer to the reference documentation for additional settings. We'll change the app name to Flight Helmet and keep the assets folder assigned to assets, since that's the name of the folder in which the model files are located. Next, we'll set the location of the rendered model. First, the pose, or location of the flight helmet, is set. We'll name the pose Helmet Pose and position at 0 on the x-axis, 0 on the y-axis, and negative 0.5 meters on the z-axis with no rotation. The flight helmet is created as an instance of the model class and is named Helmet. A model is a collection of meshes, materials, and transforms that make up a visual element. This is a great way to group together complex objects that have multiple parts in them. And in fact, most model formats are composed this way already. The model class contains a number of methods for creation. If you pass in an OBJ, STL, GLTF, or GLB file, StereoKit will load that model from file and assemble materials and transforms from the file information. This is what we'll do to render the model. We can do so using the FromFile method. FromFile takes two parameters, file and shader. The file parameter is of the type string and is the name of the file to load. It gets prefixed with the StereoKit assets folder if no drive letter is specified in the path. The shader parameter is of type shader and is used for the model's materials. If this value is null, the best shader available to use will be automatically determined. A shader is a piece of code that runs on the GPU and determines how model data gets transformed into pixels on the screen. You can provide your own shader code if you need fine control over how models are rendered. Next, a floor is created which displays that there is no view into the real world. As mentioned, this will occur if you're viewing the app in an immersive environment, such as a VR device, or on a PC screen. A floor transform is created using the TS method, which creates a transform matrix using both translate and scale. A floor material is also created, which loads a shader from the assets folder named floor.hlsl. Finally, the floor material.transparency is set to blend. This marks the rendering material as having a transparent surface that can blend with the content behind it. This allows you to see through the empty parts of the floor grid, leaving only the grid lines as visible. Here in the while statement, the code draws a model every step of the application. The application steps each frame until StereoKit is told to exit. The callback code is called every frame after input and system events, but before draw events. There's a conditional statement provided to determine whether the floor displays. Essentially, if the display type is opaque, which means there's no view into the real world, then a mesh cube is drawn using the floor material and floor transform that was created above. Next, a handle is created which enables you to grab and move objects. The handle method takes three parameters, ID, pose, and handle. The ID parameter is of type string and defines the ID of the handle group. For this example, the ID is helmet. The pose parameter is of type pose and defines the pose state for the handle. The user will be able to grab this handle and move it around. For this example, the helmet pose is used. Finally, the handle parameter is of type bounds and defines the size and location of the handle relative to the pose. For this example, the value is set to the bounds of the helmet. The draw method adds the cube model to the render queue for the current frame. This method takes one parameter, transform, which is of type matrix. This defines a matrix that will transform the model from model space into the current hierarchy space. In this example, the value for helmet pose is used and converted into a transform matrix using toMatrix. Finally, we can clean up StereoKit and all its resources using the shutdown method. To try out the app, let's build and deploy to HoloLens 2. If you're unfamiliar with how to build and deploy, refer to the project setup and deploy video for HoloLens. After deployment is complete, the app will start on your device. You can grab and move the flight helmet with your hands using a pinching motion. If instead you choose to create this project for desktop development, you would be able to view the app on your PC screen and use your mouse to grab and move the helmet. To learn more about StereoKit, visit aka.ms/StereoKit.